Hey, what's up, guys? This is Rick with The Digital Divide, and today I want to talk about comic book restoration and why there is such a big stigma over purple labels when you get your comic book graded. I don't get it. I'll never understand it. Now, their green labels, I do understand because it's a completely different situation, but for purple labels, I just never understood why there's any hesitation there whatsoever from the collector's side of the market. Now, before I go any further, let's take a look at some of the differences here. For example, CGC says that a green label means that the collectible has a significant defect. Typically what that means is that the book is not complete and it's missing pages, or it has panels cut out of the book, or there was a coupon inside that was cut out. Ultimately, though, for the most part, it means that the book is not complete and it's missing something. Or in less extreme situations, it means that the book was autographed and not witnessed. A restored purple label, though, that just means that the comic book has some repairs done so that it will appear as it did when it was in its original condition. So let's take a look at cars, for example. Say you're driving down the street, cruising along, all of a sudden your car stops running. Maybe smoke starts coming out of the engine and you're like, crap, there's something wrong here. In that situation, what would you do? Well, most people would take it to a mechanic, and the mechanic would diagnose the problem and say, hey, this is in need of repair. Your battery's dead, or your spark plugs are dead, and they need to be repaired, or they need to be replaced. And if you go to a mechanic and get those repairs done, nobody in their right mind is going to think that your car is worth less money for having those repairs done, because you're just restoring the functionality and preserving its condition. Say you're going to take the trash out, and while you're taking the trash out, you notice that somebody threw away a piece of furniture, or let's say somebody threw away an old video gaming system, and this thing is completely demolished and broken and smashed to pieces, and you think to yourself, well, I'm not gonna let this go to a landfill because it's an important piece of gaming history. So instead, you pull it out of the trash, you completely restore it, clean it up, replace any parts that are busted, and get it working so it's completely functional again. You've just restored all of the value that this thing has, because as it sits, it was completely worthless, but now it's a functional piece of gaming history again. In fact, if we look on YouTube, there's entire YouTube channels dedicated to restoring old and broken things, whether that means they're replacing parts, cleaning up parts, fixing parts. Restoration, 9 out of 10 times in any industry, improves the value or condition of a thing. The only time that appears to not be the case is when it comes to comic books. So say, for example, you have an old comic book and it's worth a lot of money, but more importantly, it has a lot of historical value and significance. But you notice one problem. The staples are starting to rust. And you know that if those staples are left in the book over time, those staples will destroy the book and it will leave the pages looking something like this. So you decide that you're not going to let the book be destroyed, and instead, because this is an important part of comic book history, you're going to replace the staples with brand new ones in order to preserve the condition of the book. In this situation, you would get a purple label because it has slight restoration. But I don't know how anyone could consider that this is a bad thing. The book itself is still completely whole, all the pages are there, they're untouched and original. The only thing you're doing is making sure that the book stays in good condition and doesn't get destroyed over time, and I just don't understand why anyone would think that that's a bad thing. Now, if we look at another example that's a bit more common, this one I don't necessarily agree with because it's not really necessary to preserve the condition of the book, but say you're one of those people who all you care about is if the book displays nicely, if it looks good on the wall, and you don't plan on selling the book, you just want to make sure it looks as nice as possible on the wall, and there's some color missing on the cover, so you decide to do some very, very slight restoration and do a little bit of color touch so that the book displays more nicely. And sometimes that color touch is so small that you need a microscope to even know that it's there. In that situation, I just don't think it's that big of a deal because the book itself is still whole. You're not taking away from it. At the end of the day, isn't that why we get books pressed and cleaned and graded? In those situations, you're also not taking away anything from the book. you're adding to its condition and preservation. When we get books graded, they're sitting in a slab anyways. We can't open them up and read them anymore. It's just to preserve the condition. Now, green labels are a completely different situation, in my opinion, because in those situations, the book is not complete. In most situations, they are missing pages. Even if the missing page doesn't affect the story, it means that the book is not complete. So the book shipped a certain way, and either pages were cut out, or coupons were cut out, or things are now missing from it, and the book is not complete. For those reasons, I will never buy a green qualified label. But for purple labels, I just never understood why there was a stigma around those. Anyways, that's going to do it for me today, guys. This was just a short rant. Let me know in the comments below what you think about purple labels.